Welcome back. Welcome to another video in my channel. Welcome to another Shopify tutorial video. So this video is after the release of Dawn 13.0.0. So on Feb 1st, 2024, Shopify has released a ton of new features. So 100 plus new feature which they have added, and I'll try my best to create all of the feature release video which they have added. But this feature which I'm going to show you guys is not available in Shopify regular plan. It's in Shopify Plus plan, which is very expensive. So if you want to implement this feature on your latest version of Dawn 13.0.0, watch the complete video and let me know in the comments below if you find any issues. So as you can see in my screen, I have this product where when I click on red color, it will only show the red color images. And it's a carousel layout on Shopify Dawn 13.0.0. And this code is going to work on all of the 13.0.0 themes. If you have Sense, Colorblock, or any of the 13.0.0 Shopify theme, it's going to work completely fine. And normally how the layout would work is this. So if you have not implemented this feature, so it will show all of the images no matter whatever color you choose. So I have this black color selected here, but I can see the red color images and white color images. And if I click again on red, you can see the featured image, the main image of the product has been changed, but in thumbnails we are seeing all of the remaining images of the products. Some more features which I'm going to show you guys is that it's going to work completely fine on desktop and the mobile version. So if I switch to the mobile version, you can see that it's only showing the black color images when selected black, and when selected red, it's only showing the red color images. And it's going to work completely fine on two column layout product page, stacked layout, or thumbnail carousel, whatever product layout you're using. So as you can see on the back end, we have currently thumbnail carousel layout enabled. So if I switch it to thumbnails, you can see it's completely working fine. And now let's switch it to some other layout like stacked layout or two columns layout. So here's the two columns layout. Again, it's working fine. And now let's switch to the stacked layout, which is the default layout when you activate that theme. Cool, right? So it's supporting all of the layout of the product page. And all you have to do is watch this video completely, subscribe to this channel, comment on the video below, and let's start implementing that. Now I'm going to go to the backend of my development store. And once you go to that and click on themes, you can see I have this Dawn 13.0.0 enabled, and I have already added all of the codes here. And this is the one without any implementation of the code. So as you can see, I have just added that last 19 minutes ago. Now I'm going to publish that. Click on publish again. And now let's preview our product. Going to close the older tabs. And here's our product, and you can see all of the images are showing up just as it's supposed to show. Okay, now that's the tutorial which we'll be following in order to implement this tutorial, and let's start get into it. And now the first step is to add the schema code. And to add the schema code, let's click on these three small dots and click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a backup of your theme, because you might be using multiple apps, or you might have already customized your product page layout or the different template layouts, so it might not work or it might conflict with the other codes which you have added. So it's better to have a duplicate of your theme, so in case it's not working, you can easily revert it back. Okay, I'm going to click on edit code, and here the first step is to go to main-product.liquid file and add our schema to line number 2207. Again, line number might be different, depend if you have any customization already added or not. So that's the screenshot of where it shows where you need to add this schema code. Okay, and that's the schema code which we will be adding. And now let's open up main-product.liquid file. scroll down, and here I'll add the code. I'm gonna zoom in so you guys can see better. Okay, so here we will add our code, add the line break, and just click on copy code button here and paste it here. Okay, after pasting this code, it's safe. Okay, now let's move on to the next step. In our next step, we will update global.js file, and in global.js file, we will need to update the update media function and add the following code within this function. Okay, now let's navigate to that file. Now I'm going to search for update media function. So here's the update media function. It's available on 1017 line number. Again, line number might be a little different for you if you already have done any customization, but if you have a fresh Dawn theme like I have, Dawn 13.0.0, you should be able to see that on 1017 line number. And that's where we will add the JS code, which is present here. So just click on copy code and then paste it here. Perfect. After adding this code, we need to add another line break here due to this bracket, which was not ending properly. So I think we should be good to go now. Now click on save. And now let's move on to the next step. Okay, so that's the next step of our code placement. And this is to replace your product-media-gallery.liquid file. Okay, now let's search for product-media-gallery.liquid. Now just replace all of the file with the code which I have provided. So click on copy code, remove all the current code, and paste the code which is within product-media-gallery.liquid file. Click on save, and that's it. Now if we take a look at the product here and hit refresh, it's not working. The reason why it's not working, that we haven't enabled that in our customize settings. So click on these three small dots and then go to customize theme. I'm going to open that in a new tab. And here, let's navigate to our product page template. So here's our product page. So within the product information, under template, we have this product information. Click here, scroll down, and here we will need to enable it. So click on this check mark here, enable selected variant images. And now you can see our selected variant is working fine. And make sure to spell it out properly. So let's go back to product information and make sure to have this color option same as here, which we have in the product backend. So if I misspell it, so for example, if I add a U, an additional U, it's gonna break the code. So make sure to have it the same as you have it on the product backend, and make sure to have the proper capitalization as well. So if you do not add in the proper capitalization, it's not gonna work as well. So make sure, because this code is case sensitive, so make sure to add this properly. If you have a multilingual store, make sure to add this option the same as you have in your product backend. And at the end, I'm gonna show you guys how you need to arrange the product images. So if it's not working for you, the reason why, you have to arrange the product images in a certain way. So let's go to the backend and create the new product. So I'm going to open the backend of my store on a new window, and I'm going to show you guys how you need to arrange your images in the product backend to make sure this code is working fine. So guys, I'm going to add a new product in order to show you guys how you can arrange the images to make this code work properly. So click on products. I'm going to click on add product. And then let's create a test t-shirt product. Add the media, add in some dummy price. I don't need to charge tax on this product. I don't need to track quantity for now. Now I'm going to upload all of the images which I have ready. So these are my product images. I'm going to upload all of these images. Okay, my product images is uploaded. Now I'm going to create color variation. So here we can add an option. Click on add options, select color here. And as I have red, black and white color images, I'm going to add in the same option. So let's add in black first, red, and then white. Again, make sure to have this same spelling as we have in our customized settings. So in our customized settings, we have mentioned COLOR with capital C. We have the same here on our option name. Cool. Now click on save. Okay, our product is created and we have uploaded some images. We have added the pricing. We have added the variation. And now we will select the variant image for each product. And before doing so, arrange the images. So make sure black color is all aligned, red and white. Just like I have here mentioned in our fourth step, where we will have to arrange black images, red images and white images aligned in one single row. So I'm going to make sure my black image doesn't have any red images in between. Now I'm going to move this red one here and then red one here. So we have images aligned properly, right? Black in one line, then red in the other, and then the white on the third row. Okay. Now after doing that, make sure to select the first image of that specific color as a variant image. So this image will be the variant image for the black color. This image will be the variant image for the red color, and this image will be the variant image for the white color. Now let's do that. Click on edit here. And now let's select the black color image. So I'm going to select the black and then click on save. Similarly, we'll do that for the red and white color. Click on save. Cool. Now let's preview our product to make sure it's working fine. Click on preview. And here we go. Our selected variant images are working completely fine. And it will not work if I move these images misaligned. So if I misalign these images, so let's move on the red one here. And let's move on the white one here. And now if I check my product, it's not going to work properly. You can see in black color, I have all of the images showing up. Red is working fine, but you can see the main product, main color variation is not working fine. So make sure you have images aligned properly. And the first image of each color is selected as variant image. Cool. Now let's go back to the product, hit refresh. And now you can see that selected variant images is working fine. Cool, right? So that's it for the video, guys. Make sure to leave a comment below if you have any issues or if you are looking to get some more new tutorials. I'm working hard with my team to create more and more tutorial for you guys. And I'm trying to catch up with the comments. And there are a few updates which have made the Swatches tutorials stop working. We are working on it and we will surely release new videos after fixing those issues. So until next video, have a great day.